gardens are our sanctuaries, peaceful, private, plant-filled corners of this green and pleasant land.
But not everyone has caught the gardening bug. Some of the gardens you're about to see are shocking.
This is so bad.
So monstrous, they're crimes against nature itself.
Don't want to admit that something like this is your own, do you?
It's like a bomb site.
It is depressing. I hate coming out.
In a lifetime of gardening, I've never seen gardens so bad. But help is at hand. I've assembled a crack team to help rehabilitate some of the worst gardens in Britain. Garden designer Danny believes he can bring out the gardener in everyone.
Encouraging people to grow into gardeners is just as satisfying to me as seeing their gardens grow.
Can't believe that that's how easy it is.
For Penny, it's all about the power tools.
With these tools in my hand, I can cut down and clear out, or I can rescue and recycle.
Absolutely brilliant.
Everyone has what it takes to look after a garden, and we're on a mission to show you how easy it really is.
Nice one. Looks good.
It's time to turn Britain's filthiest gardens
into fabulous gardens.
Wow, look at this.
This is amazing world to us.
Absolutely unbelievable.
It's beautiful.
Just can't get over it.
I don't think I've ever seen a garden so beautiful in all my life.
This is Filthy Garden SOS.
This time, a mother and daughter whose home renovations turned their garden into a builder's yard.
It was just easier than getting a skip.
But have seen the error of their ways.
I'm very ashamed.
You want to get back your dignity?
Yes.
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 We're in beautiful Bangor in northwest Wales, and at Mum of Tree Amber's house, it's dinner time. The inside of the house might be spick and span, but outside is a garden that's absolutely gruesome. But now Amber and her 23-year-old daughter Shona have decided enough is enough.
The garden currently, it's like a bomb site.
There's a toilet, there's a fridge freezer, my sister's old bed, and just loads of rubble.
I feel embarrassed to see the garden the way it is now.
2 years ago, my dad decided to build an extension. It was just easier for us to get all the rubble and dump it in the garden rather than getting a skip.
I'm very ashamed. Very, very ashamed.
Amber's partner of 27 years, Stuart, runs his own haulage business, transporting local slate, leaving him no time to tackle the garden.
Stuart is a workaholic.
I do worry about my dad, his health, because he does do too much. I want to get the garden sorted because it'll be one less thing then off his list done.
I'm willing all the hard graft and the work that needs to be done.
I'm willing to roll my sleeves up and get my hands in the mud.
And when owners of filthy gardens are prepared to do that, then we're happy to help out.
What blue skies are out. It's incredible, you know, come to Wales.
I'm wondering what we're in for today, Dermot. I really am.
And Penny's already at the location, waiting for us.
Yeah, it's just here. Look, look, just there. There's Penny.
Just what I love to say first thing in the morning. Woman prepared.
Always prepared, me.
Oh, Lordy, look at this.
There's been loads of building work going on here.
This is very depressing.
Oh, it gets worse.
I've not seen anything like it in my life. It looks absolutely dreadful.
This is unbelievable. How can anyone call this a garden? It's shocking. There's a bed, there's a fridge.
Pipes, plastic, water, cement.
It's a tip. It's a tip in the literal sense of the word.
It breaks my heart. It truly does. It's just a waste of space.
There's no doubt about it. It's a dump. We really need to get to the bottom of this. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Fine, thank
Hello.
You.
Hello.
So, Amber and Shona, you've called for our help.
Yes, we have.
That's Penny and Danny
Hi.
Over there.
Hi.
It's just a tip.
Yes.
How did that happen?
We thought it's time now that we get an extension. So everything was just chucked out.
Then why not do something?
Because Stuart is working more hours now.
Stuart is your hubby?
Yes.
What's his job?
He's a haulage driver. He's got his own business.
This might sound a bit harsh, but why didn't he get one of his men to come and collect all this with one of his lorries?
I don't think he's got the time to do it, to be honest with you.
And how does it feel if somebody unexpected came to the house and had a look? How do you feel?
Embarrassing. Degrading, to be honest with you. I feel disgusted with myself. Not a nice feeling at all.
So why now? Why decide that you should do something after letting it kind of rot like this for a few years?
Well, it's my sister's 21st in a few weeks. So the least we can do is try and get the garden sorted and make it a nice space for my sister to enjoy her birthday.
So really, you're very sociable people. You like to have people around. And this space is totally not being used for that.
Yes, it's totally wasted.
You want a place for the party, but you also want to get back your dignity?
Yes. Yes.
And I know it would definitely be a big weight off my father's shoulders.
Why is that so important to you?
He works so hard. He runs after everyone, and he keeps the house going and everything.
And you're really committed to making a change?
Oh, yes. I'm raring to go.
Really?
I can't wait to start.
Do you know, that was a difficult conversation. Amber used words like disgust and shame, and she was brimming with emotion. And what she's talking about is a garden that could be sorted. It needs a little bit of get up and go.
We need to blitz this grievous garden, so I've called in a skip and a team to help with the clearance.
It's just so exciting. Everything's going to be moved now. We're going to start getting things done.
When the fridge will be going to the skip, I might dance naked around the estate.
Oh, steady on, Amber. We've got just 5 days to fix 2 years of neglect. It's a big moment for Amber and Shona to turn over a new leaf and finally start clearing out.
Hold on. What I don't understand is how can you be so house proud and then so not garden proud?
I know if I had somebody with me
to
like push me,
okay,
I would do it.
Sorry, I know it sounds like tough love, but I just want you to remember how awful this feels right now so that when it's finished, you feel amazing.
I will. I'll cherish this moment.
Yeah, but you're doing an amazing job.
Thank you.
All right.
Yes, thank you.
I want to see plant pots, not paint pots. Let's get rid of this lot.
Okay.
Tell me, what is your experience of gardening? You grew up in Wales?
Yes.
In a place like this?
Yes. We had a lovely garden. My father, he had lovely rose bushes and big, tall gladiolus. And we were only allowed to look, but not touch.
And did you enjoy the garden at all at home?
No, we weren't given the opportunity back then.
You're joking?
No.
Are you scared of it?
I am, a little bit, yes, I am. But I'm willing to learn.
The skip is filling up fast, but I want a team meeting to discuss our plans for the build.
It's great to get a breather for a few minutes, isn't it?
Lovely.
I've had an interesting little chat with Amber. She was telling me her dad grew gladioli and roses, but he said, look, but don't touch. So that could...
Really?
Yeah, I'd really like to get her gardening because of that.
I think she was affected by her childhood. She wants that garden again. She wants a beautiful space. Mm-hmm.
Shauna's very impressive. She's interested in the effect that the garden has on Mum and Dad. Yes. She wants that burden lifted off both. But she also knows that Emily, her sister, is about to be 21. It should be a venue for a party. Mm-hmm. So the garden needs to be appropriate to a younger generation, but also to Mum and Dad. Two different things.
Yeah, it's going to work on different levels, isn't it?
What we're going to create for Amber, Shauna, Stuart and the family is a low-maintenance space that combines local materials like Welsh slate with fashionable plants such as bamboo, which don't need a huge amount of care. There'll be a cool contemporary space for younger members of the family with dramatic plants, and a relaxing space for Mum and Dad with the cottage garden feel of Amber's childhood.
But there's a lot of work to do before we get there. Saying goodbye to 3 tonnes of mess is a great start.
Oh, fantastic.
It's an amazing moment because so much of the cause of the problem is about to be lifted out and taken away. And it represents a fresh start.
Goodbye, my friend.
Bye, rubbish. Goodbye. See you never.
We'll never see you again.
Never. Yeah.
The carnage they've created in this garden means there's still so much more to do before we can even think about building it up again.
It's unbelievable the amount of rubbish that's in that garden. And there's a load more to come out yet.
Whilst we've cleared a workable section to get cracking with the build, there's still a lot of debris in other corners which the team need to clear out. But that's going to have to wait until tomorrow. At least Amber and Shauna have proven to us that they're committed to transforming their grim garden.
After seeing what we've done today, what we really needed was a kick up the bum.
There's no going back now, and I can't wait to see what tomorrow brings.
Coming up...
Let's get going.
As the carnage continues to be cleared, Penny's got a major problem with some tree trunks.
There's metal wire within the actual tree trunks. I'm not able to cut it now with my chainsaw.
And calls in some machinery muscle. And our plans for the garden design are revealed.
I'm speechless. I've got tears in my eyes now.
Oh.
In Bangor, Penny, Danny and I have been called in to help Amber and Shauna reclaim a garden from the dump site they created.
I've not seen anything like it in my life.
With some hard graft, we've already shifted 3 tonnes of rubbish.
Goodbye, my friend.
Bye, rubbish.
But there's so much more to do if we're going to transform this unused space into an easy-to-look-after garden, with a contemporary and dramatic hangout for the younger family members and a relaxing, more traditional garden where Dad Stuart can unwind. It's time to share our plans.
Well, Amber and Shauna, do you know what? You have shown your dedication. Show us your finger.
I see some dirt under those nails.
What we've done is cleared a space. Now you're not ashamed looking at it, are you?
No.
But you wanted more. You wanted the garden. And that's what we intend to give you. So we have plans in mind to create a garden that is usable. A space here that you can follow the sun, a big paved area around here. We're going to have lavender of that sort of romantic kind of cottage garden plant down around there. And over here, we're going to have the brash disco plants, the big architectural things, the youngsters things. So it's going to be a garden of plants, and it's going to be a garden of usable space.
I'm all over the paving. So up here, we're going to have lovely, gorgeous Indian sandstone. And then coming down here, there's an ode to your dad's. We're going to have beautiful slates.
But the piece de la resistance. You're going to have a structure here that's going to be a place for you to sit in with your family and friends. This is going to be the talk of the town. You're going to absolutely love it.
I'm speechless. I've got tears in my eyes now.
Oh,
Mum.
I'm honestly so buzzing. I can't wait to see it.
Well, we've got a lot to live up to now, haven't we? We've set the bar. We've set the standard really high, because we certainly haven't played this down.
And there's a huge amount of work needed before we can give them the garden of their dreams.
I know the plan is for a bamboo border, but I like the traditional look of the conifers, and I think they should stay.
Because it's been left go unkempt, I think the only thing for it is to rip it out.
I completely disagree. I'm thinking that these create a really nice barrier, shading the garden since it's such a sunny spot. I have a thought. Shall we ask Amber and Shona what they think and they can do the deciding?
Good idea.
Shona and Amber!
What do you think? We're having a garden argument here. I think this hedge should go.
I don't.
I don't like it. I agree with Dermot.
So do I. I think it's time to get rid of them.
3-1, I've definitely lost this one. And I suppose at least bamboo will be much easier to maintain.
I've had an idea to make planters out of some old wine crates for Dermot to start planting in tomorrow.
Good way to get started with gardening, if you find it daunting, is to start with planters or pots.
They allow new gardeners to experiment and build their confidence on a more manageable scale. The first step is to line a planter with a porous material.
So the reason we're doing this is so the soil doesn't go through these gaps in the planters, and it allows the soil to stay there, but also enables water to penetrate through.
Shona's mucking in with me, and she's learning that soil can be a beautiful thing.
How's it feel, Shona?
Do you know what, Danny? It's not that bad.
It isn't, is it?
No.
It's absolutely wonderful. That's why we call it black gold. It feels brilliant because it's part of us.
Another great thing is that with containers, you can have a varied scenery because you can move them around.
It's a bit like moving the furniture in your living room. Planters give you flexibility to keep refreshing how the garden looks.
Right, Shona, all these are ready for planting. They're looking great, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
I need Amber and Shona to get really excited about what plants their garden can be filled with. And what better place to inspire them than Krug Farm in Carnarvon, home to more than 4,000 different perennials, shrubs, flowers and trees, collected from all over the globe.
Hello.
Hello. Hiya.
So how long did it take you to get here from your house?
About 15 minutes.
15 minutes, OK. I have brought you to one of the world's centres of horticulture, of gardening, of plants. And for me, it's like being in Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. Come here. Those white flowers are from a plant called Pachyphragma, and it's amazing. It's a relative of the cabbage, believe it or not.
Amazing.
From one that's on the ground to one growing up here. It's a Chef Lyra from Taiwan, and it's my favourite plant that I have growing in my garden, and it came from 15 minutes from your house.
To see different kind of plants and trees I've never even seen in my life, it is an incredible place.
If there was one plant that I could take home with me today, it would be one of these. It's called Cardiocranum, and it's a giant lily, and it's the most extraordinary thing you will ever see.
I definitely feel inspired today after hearing Dermot talking about all these plants and how he's so passionate about them. I will now look at plants and flowers in a different way from now on.
It's an eye-opener to come to a place like this. It's been an amazing day, hasn't it, Shona?
Back at the house, I need to remove those conifers. Time to get my toys out.
My favourite part of gardening is when I get to use my tools. Right now, I need to use my chainsaw, and these two big trunks are in the way.
But there's a problem. As the trees have grown, they've actually become intertwined with the metal fence, which can damage my chainsaw.
There's metal wire within the actual tree trunks. I'm not able to cut it now with my chainsaw. I'm going to have to ask the lads to come and help me with the digger. We're already in a really tight schedule here. This is a nightmare.
Luckily, a mini digger versus Lalandai is no contest.
It's a bit stressful.
Now Amber and Shona have returned from their visit to the farm, I have a surprise in store for them. Now that conifer boundary has been cleared, the garden has gone from this to this.
Oh my God. I'm just shocked to see the space in the garden.
Well done.
Thank you.
It really is a blank canvas now, isn't it?
Yes.
It's a fresh start.
It makes the garden much bigger.
Penny has definitely waved the flag for girl power. We're so proud of her. You can actually finally see the space that we've got.
Oh, it's massive.
I think you're going to gain about a metre. That's a lot of garden.
Yes, it is.
I think they owe me a beer for my hard work today.
It's too early for beers, Penny. It's the end of day two, and we haven't even started the build yet. We need to pick up the pace with this project if we're going to finish on time.
There are so many elements that can set this project back. It could be the weather, anything like that. But I'm very confident we're going to produce a great garden for Amber and Shona. There's no doubt about that.
Coming up...
Try and spread it out.
Penny turns teacher.
Nice one!
Danny starts on the structure.
It's going to make a brilliant focal point, and I'm really excited by it.
And Amber and Shona put their fingerprints on the garden.
Have you ever planted anything before?
Never.
So this is a special moment.
We're in Bangor, helping mum and daughter, Amber and Shona, get their filthy garden...
It's a dump.
...ready to be a fabulous one.
I'm just shocked to see the space that had been wasted all this time in the garden.
It's a glorious morning, and the team hit the location early to get cracking on this much-needed garden transformation.
Ah, morning, Penny.
Morning. How are you?
I'm ready for action. We've a busy day in store, but it's quite an exciting day. We've cleared areas ready to build structures and prepare soil for planting. I'm excited.
I'm feeling energised now. The garden looks completely different to what we started with.
We're working on three distinct areas in the garden today. I'll be doing the planting, my absolute favourite thing to do, whilst Penny is working on the paving and Danny's in charge of the structure. And Amber and Shona will be finding out that gardening needn't be daunting.
It looks like we've got a load of white colour today, and that means hard work.
I have got one of the most prominent pieces in the garden to tackle today, and I'm really excited by it. It's going to be a structure that's going to make a brilliant focal point. It's going to be for the family to enjoy, especially the youngsters, and also it's going to double up as a greenhouse too. So it's going to be multi-purpose.
While Danny gets started on the structure, I'm enlisting Shona to help me with a very important job.
Shona and Amber and the rest of the family for the last 2+ years have had nowhere to sit in the garden. So today I'm going to be creating the paving area so that they can have a space or sanctuary where they can just chill out and relax. Hey, Shona.
Hiya.
So I'm going to teach you how to lay paving.
I've never done anything like this before.
That's okay. That's what I'm here for. That's what I'll teach you. So when it comes to laying paving, you have to remember the three P's. Preparation, preparation, preparation. When you get the preparation right, everything else is easy. So, first things first, it's hardcore. If you get this right, you get your paving right.
Hardcore is the term given to the base layer of crushed stone that stops the paving from sinking.
Because we're in Wales, their hardcore is crushed slate, which is a byproduct of the slate that they mine in the quarries, which just gives it a really solid base, and we compact that down using a whacker plate, and that tightens everything up, ready for laying the slabs and the cement.
There are two methods of putting down cement. One is called dotting and dabbing, where you simply put a bit of cement down in the four corners and the centre. And the other method, which uses more cement mix but gives you a much stronger hold, is called a full bed. After you lay the slab down, just tap down with a mallet and use the spirit level to make sure you're dead level with the rest of the paving. Okay, we're good. Do you want to have a shot?
Yeah.
Good. Try and spread it out. Shona has already put a PVA glue solution on the slabs that increases the bond with the mortar, and it creates a barrier to stop the lime in the cement from staining the paving. Bash down until it looks, with your eye, obviously looks level. Yeah, that's good. Okay, now grab that. Spirit level. Nice one. Looks good. Well done.
Thank you. It was amazing. I really didn't think I could do it. Like I say to my friends, I laid that slab down.
From paving to planting, I'm putting those new planters that Danny created yesterday to good use. We're going to create a portable herb garden.
Have you ever planted anything before?
Never.
Never, ever, ever?
Never, ever.
It's time to show Amber, with this oregano, just how easy planting is.
I've just squeezed the pot, eased it out of its plant, and then I'm just going to get my thumb in and I'm going to tear the roots just a little bit. Stimulate new growth. The principle of planting is the same everywhere, whether it's in the garden or in a pot. I'm going to use my hand. I'm going to scoop out a hole in the compost. I'm going to drop that plant in to the same level that the compost was at and just firm it down. So this is a special moment. I want you to plant that mint for me. Now, that's a very healthy root system there. Happy-looking plant. Just scooping that lovely compost. Absolutely beautifully done. Congratulations, your first plant.
Yes. I thought there was more work to it than that.
If you put this in a sunny situation, it will now do all the work for you. And there is no more mystery to the craft of gardening than that. And what you've started today is to start the first planting of your garden, because this crate is going to go in on your new terrace.
Lovely.
For this time-strapped family, the high-maintenance conifers are out, and in its place, a striking bamboo hedge that will need hardly any maintenance.
It'll grow wonderfully here because it loves the rainfall we get in this part of Wales.
Now I've dug the channel, Penny and I are putting in a fabric root barrier to stop the bamboo running amok.
These guys are runners. They will run left and right, and they'll pop up wherever they can. This will act like a trough in the ground, and it'll keep these roots and these shoots at bay. Great. Thank you.
Time to give Amber another leafy lesson.
So, Amber, what do you think I'm doing here?
Planting trees.
I am planting, but they're not trees. They're bamboos. So they're a type of grass, actually. They're from the Orient, and we've been using them in gardens in these islands for kind of centuries because they love growing here. They love moisture, they love the dampness of our climate, and you don't need to do much to look after them. So they're perfect for you.
Yes. I haven't seen bamboo plants before. They are a good replacement to the conifer hedge.
Amber's becoming more green-fingered by the minute.
I've been busy planting oregano, mint and some bamboo, and I can't wait to plant more.
Meanwhile, Danny's at the back of the garden where the structure is starting to take shape. He's making it extra secure against the Welsh wind.
I think it's looking fabulous. The 4x2 struts are in place, and these cross beams are giving the whole structure some strength, and that's very important.
We've thrown tons of rubbish out of this garden, but not everything is going in the skip. I found a couple of items that I think might look lovely in our new setting.
These are old chimney pots.
Oh, they're wonderful, aren't they?
Aren't they? I was thinking about lanterns.
That is an idea.
It's amazing when you're in the garden and you find loads of things that you want to upcycle. The saying, one man's junk is another man's treasure, is so true.
As the day draws to a close, this garden is really starting to look like the magical place we wanted to create for Amber, Shona and the family.
Do you know what? I'm really loving the shape of the structure.
Do you know, I love the shape. I think it's wonderful.
It was a great day to see them getting stuck in and getting their hands dirty. I love that. And today we saw them plant their first plants ever, and then their second and third and fourth.
I mean, casting my eye on Amber, she's had a smile on her face. That was just complete and utter joy as far as I was concerned.
I can't wait to see what we're going to do next.
Tomorrow, new venture.
Yes.
It's the big reveal tomorrow, so we'll be insanely busy.
There's still loads to do, and I'm really nervous about getting this finished on time.
Coming up...
Shall we put that in the box, then?
Amber and Shona show just what they've learned as the build has progressed.
Amber, you're blossoming in front of my eyes, and it's the most wonderful thing to see.
And Stuart finally gets to see our garden transformation.
Oh, my God.
We're in Bangor transforming a garden that was basically a rubbish dump.
There's a bed, there's a fridge.
Pipes, plastic, water, cement.
And we've come to the last day of our garden build.
Big day today, final day, all about planting and revealing.
In a few hours, this garden's transformation from grotty to gorgeous will be complete.
I think my dad is very excited. I think he's like a kid waiting for Santa Claus to come.
When Stuart came home from work last night, he told me to close the kitchen blinds because he didn't want to see anything of the garden until today.
The garden is a hive of activity as we race to finish our makeover.
This structure is the biggest feature of the new design, and it's really coming together now.
I'm turning my salvaged chimney pots into ornamental lanterns with the help of battery-powered fairy lights.
I'll pop all the lights in there, and then at night time you've got this beautiful glow that comes out of these slits at the top. I love upcycling, and do you know what? Not everyone's going to have the same thing if you do that. How boring is it when everyone has the same things?
It's very important that we attract wildlife into the garden. Now, this plant is called Viburnum burgwoodii. It's absolutely gorgeous. And one of the reasons I like it, it's got such a beautiful scent. The bees and the butterflies are going to absolutely love it.
I need to know that we're leaving this garden in safe hands. It's time to find out what Amber and Shona have learned.
Remembering the things that we've talked about on our visit to the nursery and remembering what we've learned about planting, I want you to arrange those plants from there through to there.
OK. Do you want to cut it?
Yeah. No, I think you should go put there.
Shall we put that in the box, then?
I really want to see if Amber and Shona think about the way these plants can be laid out to create a real impact on the eye, to set the garden off and invite people in.
That one a bit more up.
I love the way you're working because you're thinking about it. I think you did very well, really well. Stroke of genius, putting the pieris there. It's an evergreen plant. And just outside the kitchen window, that's become the focal point. So we call that the specimen. That's the one that stands up and the others form clouds around its base, top marks. Over there, a brilliant idea to put the hydrangea there because it's the first thing you see as you walk up and that's going to do beautifully there.
I'm really pleased with myself because I put the potted plants the way they should have been placed. I felt so proud of myself.
Amber, you're blossoming in front of my eyes, and it's the most wonderful thing to see. I'm so encouraged in terms of you taking over this garden and encouraging it to bloom. It is going to work.
When Dermot said I had a knife for planting, I was a bit emotional, you know.
I know, I saw it. I did think of Grandad looking down at you and thinking, oh, do you know what? Go on, girl. You've done me proud.
I've showed him proud today, haven't I?
Yeah, you have, definitely.
With the big reveal fast approaching, we've sent Amber and Shona away from the house.
I can't believe we're so close to the finishing line. My stomach is turning now, you know.
It's shaping up. It is always the planting that brings everything together. So this is Trachycarpus fortunii. It's a hardy palm. It will make the big statement that we need.
At the top end of the garden, our focus is on the younger generation. We're thinking about Emily and her upcoming 21st party.
The younger folk really are influenced by social media, and they love the idea of that subtropical feel outside. And even in Wales, that's exactly what we're going to give them.
We're taking inspiration from plants with dramatic foliage, just like the Chef Lyra plant we saw at Crewe Farm.
This is a wonderful plant. You'll never guess what it is. It's a banana. It won't produce fruit in this country. And it just looks so dramatic. I can't wait to get it in the ground.
The planting is nearly done, and the chill out space and optional greenhouse is finished.
I love this space. It feels really secluded and really private. But having said that, you're still connected with the garden because of these transparent sides.
And we've got a few surprises for Amber and Shona. Anyone for a disco? With the clock ticking, it's a frantic push to get everything into position. But at last, this garden transformation is complete. Just a few days ago, this place was an absolute dump, full of rubble and debris, and Amber was suffering.
I feel disgusted with myself. Not a nice feeling at all.
But now, it's a beautiful, inviting space with a gorgeous paved area that's perfect for socialising. And an amazing structure that serves as both a hangout and a greenhouse. It's a garden for all ages, with a back area full of super cool, dramatic plants that will appeal to the younger generation, as will the hip and modern line of bamboo that's replaced the unruly conifer hedge. Whilst towards the front, we've created a cottage garden with plants like hydrangeas, hosta, pieris and osteospermum that will remind Amber of her childhood.
I'm very proud of the way it's been transformed.
It's been 2 years of mayhem. In a few days, we've made it into the most beautiful, peaceful place of sanctuary for the whole family.
Although Amber and Shona have helped to turn this garden around, we sent them away for the final changes. And now they get to see what's been done.
Amber and Shona, come on out. Come on, step out and have a look at your new garden.
I'm speechless.
I can't believe it. It actually looks like a garden.
The best transformation ever.
Just 5 days ago, the view from Amber's kitchen was so bad she used to close the blinds so she couldn't see the mess. Now the view from her back door couldn't be more different.
I never could imagine having our little garden as amazing as this.
I'm actually blown away.
It's amazing.
Time for Stuart and the rest of the family to see the transformation.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh my God.
A lot of work. Oh, absolutely fantastic.
What do you think, Stuart?
Did you give your skin money out? Money out? You could put it in.
Unbelievable.
Thank you for what you've done for him.
Thank you.
God Almighty.
Your family tell us you work very hard to provide for them, and they felt the garden was quite a pressure for you, because you had no time to tackle it.
No.
So, Shona and Amber got together. Sorted.
Thank you. Thank you. Amazing. Thank you very much.
Shauna and Amber are proud to show off the results of all their hard work. The rubble and debris that had turned this garden into a dump are a distant memory. It's hit Stuart for six.
Absolutely unbelievable.
I don't think I've ever seen a garden so beautiful in all my life.
And now Emily will be able to celebrate her 21st in style.
Do you feel the warmth when you come in?
Yeah, it's amazing.
And look at the glitter ball. It's ideal for your 21st, isn't it?
It is. It's a 10 out of 10.
It is.
I think we really hit the mark with this garden, don't you?
Absolutely.
It is all ages. That's what they wanted. Everybody's enjoying everything.
Absolutely.
It's nice to see.
It's definitely a garden for everybody, isn't it? It's cross-generational.
Shauna and Amber, as we're saying our goodbyes...
The symbolism of us handing the garden over to you. Here you are. One for you. One for you.
Oh, wow.
Enjoy.
It's been a pleasure working with you to create this, and all we want to say is happy gardening, happy families.
Enjoy your garden. It's now yours.
Yes.
Promise you'll look after it?
We will.
Good.
We will.
Okay. And when you get your next veg, don't be throwing that out in the garden, yeah?
We promise.
Okay, yes. We'll love you and leave you. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Amazing.
When I saw the garden, it was a complete and utter mess. But now, it's been completely transformed. It's an oasis.
It's been 2 years of putting up with the garden as a rubbish tip. And finally, there's sense, there's order.
And the best bit about this garden? It's a low-maintenance space that will take just a half a day each month to keep blooming. Especially now we've given them green fingers.
We've given them the knowledge and the tools and the passion and the drive to keep their garden beautiful, vibrant and clean and maintain it. It's just up to them now.
So here's to our new beautiful garden.
Cheers!
And I must say, Shauna, this one cheers for my dad up there.
Yes.
For saying you can look but you can't touch. But this is my garden now and I am going to touch, so...
Cheers, Dad!
And just a few weeks later, Emily celebrated her 21st in style. Although there was an addition of one thing to the garden that helped the party go with a splash. For more information about this programme, go to channel5.com/filthygardenSOS.
Catch more Filthy Garden SOS brand new next Sunday at 7. Jane McDonald's going back to her roots tonight, taking us on a tour of the place she calls home in My Yorkshire, starting brand new at 9. First, making a living's a whole lot more fun over on the Costas as the party kicks off with our bargain-loving Brits in the Sun. New next.
Thank you.
Thank you.